welcome to the Wachita Sports Digital Network presented by Taylor King Law. It is senior night for Wachita Wrestling, and we are ready to present the seniors, so we will do our best for you to be able to hear. You'll have the names on the screen, but we will do the best we can. Not the best acoustics here, but we'll do the best we can to bring the names to you. First senior, Noah Yemans, graduating with a finance degree. Keelan Stanley is the next senior. Keelan will be graduating in the spring with a kinesiology and science degree. Was Keelan Stanley. Alex Tice is the next senior. He'll be graduating in the spring with a business administration degree. All of these seniors being joined by Coach Kretschmer and their escorts on the field. That was Alex Tice. Johnny Green is the next senior. Johnny will be graduating next spring with a business management degree. Chandler Cooley, the next senior, will also be graduating in the spring with a business administration degree with an emphasis in entrepreneurship. Jesse Hodge will be graduating in the spring with a kinesiology degree. Marcel Malou, joined by the team, will be graduating with a finance degree in the spring. Coach Kretschmer is going to have all the seniors come out and take a group shot, and then after that we'll have wrestling Ouachita versus Carl Albert State College in a few minutes, a little after 6 p.m.
Thank you.
thank you for tuning in to the Ouachita Sports Digital Network. It is Ouachita versus Carl Albert State College in tonight's match. Noah Yemens and Caden Betts in the 125. Yemens takes a 16-0 win at the 59-second mark of round one. And next, it will be the 133 weight class. James Anderson for Ouachita and Thaddeus Long. For Carl Albert. Thank you. right, so the final in the 133 weight class, Long of Carl Albert defeats Anderson 17-8. Our next will be the 141 weight class. Chris Babb here, and joined now by Ricky Rogers Jr., someone who knows a little bit more about wrestling than we do. Ricky, thanks for joining us, and kind of take us through these matches as we go. We've got the 141 for Ouachita. It'll be Hudson Herring, and for Carl Albert, it will be RT Noel. So Ouachita wins the 125 weight class, Betts with a Tech fall, and Carl Albert wins the 133 weight class, and now we're ready for 141. Ricky, this is never the class that you wrestled in, is it?
Oh, no, sir. I couldn't dream of being down at this weight, Coach.
All right, there you get a good look at Herring as he is waiting. Hudson Herring ready to go. All right, so Ricky, take us through this. Carl Albert, State College out of Oklahoma, the 141, and we'll let you get a good look at it. You can stand up. You got plenty of room there with that mic as we get going. I guess it weren't ready at the table, so we're going to reset that. Ricky, you've... You've wrestled a lot. What are the competitors going through right now? Right before, you know, you have the warm up, and then you have all the build up, and then it's your turn for it's just you and the opponent. You know, so what's going through their minds right now?
I mean, Coach, this isn't like any other sport. You know, in football and basketball, there's a team, and you know you're with your teammates out there. But in wrestling, all eyes are on you. You're in the middle of the mat. It's just you and this other guy. So it's just nerves. All I can say, Coach, nerves. But once you start putting hands on each other, once you start getting to the flow of things, all those nerves start to go away. So I know that's what Hudson's feeling right now. And I know Hudson, and he's a pretty tough wrestler, Coach. He's got good hand fight, good shots. He's pretty solid on top. So I'm really excited to see this match.
All right, Ouachita, little delay here. We are at the Sturgis Physical Education Center, senior night. Ouachita recognized six seniors before the match. And now these 141, you can kind of get a good look at the two competitors just kind of walking around. They probably don't like this delay in what they have. It's probably not exactly what they were prepared for mentally, is it?
Right. No, sir. Not at all.
But just like anything else, you just kind of have to shake it off and go on.
Yes, sir. Just roll with the punches.
A little bit more of an extended delay. Let's kind of take a look at what's coming up next in the 149, then 157. And we'll kind of – we got a preliminary lineup beforehand, so we'll try to bring those to you as we go. Xander Field, Jason Pena in the 149, and then Jalen Otero, 157. 174, Cole Eason, William Martin, and then – getting up there, Johnny Green, Donald Paul with the 185, 197, Brooks Schemeyer. So now we're ready to go with the 141. So many different strategies, Rick, for being able to, you know, whether you want to get control at the beginning or what are some of the strategies that some wrestlers are using at the beginning of that round to see whether they want to get control or feel the opponent out?
Yes, sir. Right off the bat, you want to make the other opponent feel your hand fight. You want to show dominance right from the beginning. And that's exactly what Hudson and his opponent is doing right now, trying to fight for underhooks, collar ties. I can tell Hudson is very, very heavy on his collar tie right now, just trying to assert dominance so that I can set up their shots.
Herring gets on the board. Noel gets on the board first for Carl Albert. Trying to maintain control, and Herring's going to try to get out of it.
Yes, sir. Notice how heavy he is right now on top, how he uses that tight waist to keep Hudson on the ground. What Hudson needs to do right now is drive those knees up and build his base so he can work on getting out.
It is December. Today's December 7th. Normally, December 7th, you're going to have cool weather, but it has been anything but that. 70 degrees today, humid here in the lower gym, so I would imagine at some point the mat comes into play with that as well, as Noel gets two more points and up 4-0. I would imagine at some point the humidity and the moisture on the mat affects the wrestling as well.
Oh, yes, sir. Let me tell you, that mat will get slick once everybody starts warming up and gets to sweating.
That's why you see the four fans on each corner. There, one in your screen there under the scoreboard. It is an unseasonably warm near fall for, well, so 8-0 now as we have 40 seconds left in the first round.
Yes, sir. Hudson's opponent's doing a really, really good job of staying heavy on top, making Hudson feel his weight and getting some back points. And right there, Hudson just hip heist to get out, and now he can get to work in the neutral position to get his takedowns.
And sometimes when you are up 8-0, you're not going to mind giving away that point if you feel like you're not going to be able to get any further with where you were. Give up the point, try to regroup and get another one.
Right, yes, sir. There's no point if he's already getting out just to let him go and to keep working in neutral, especially since he already got that early takedown at the beginning of the period.
Under 10 seconds to go here in the first period of the 141 weight class, and at the end of one, 8-1 lead for, well, from Carl Albert as we go to round two. So what is
Right now Hudson is going to start on bottom, because at the end of the at the beginning of the second and third period, you're going to get the choice top, bottom, neutral, the first, and right there Hudson just picked bottom. Right here, Coach Babb, Hudson's opponent, put legs in on Hudson. I can tell you from experience, this sucks. You feeling all of their weight, how he puts his legs in, and his legs right now, Hudson's feeling all of his opponent's weight, and it's very tough to get at him. But right there, Hudson just escaped and reversed it for 2 points.
The reversal for Hudson Herring gets back to 8-3. And now just that quickly, another escape, so back to 9-3. Hudson had been down 8-1 and had all that weight, and then if you're able to quickly get out of it and reverse.
Yes, sir.
He's trying to, you know, who knows what can happen, but then Noel did a nice job of getting out of it, getting back to neutral.
Yes, sir. Down in on a shot, looking to score. Hudson's doing a very good job of keeping his hips down on his opponent to prevent the takedown.
Trying to get around to get control, but he's just got that right arm locked in there, not letting him get around. And that is how the second period ends, 9-3. So a little more even there. And so now as we go to round three, what is the strategy here for both competitors?
So for both competitors, for Hudson's opponent, he's doing a really good job on top and a really good job controlling the hand fight. So I say if he sticks to that, he'll be good. But Hudson has proven that he can get out from bottom when he reversed him with that too. And he's proven that he can stop his opponent's shots. So he needs to, on right here, get a tough ride, manage to tilt, or get to his feet and control the hand fight to get to his takedowns.
This is the third period. Sorry, Rick. For some reason, our score ticker is not updating the period. So it's 9-3 with 1:37 actually remaining in the third period. And 11-3 now the lead for Noel from Carl Albert. Just that quickly, hearing reverses, gets two. Rick, when you get to a minute 15 left in the third and you're down six, you're really trying to get the pin, I guess.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're definitely trying to look for the pin. You're trying to get to your, as they say, they're trying to get to your stuff, trying to get to your pinning combinations, and you can tell that's what Hudson's doing right now. He's very, very close to locking up that cradle. I know Hudson really loves that cradle. He almost got it there.
So when you're up 6 points and your opponent is trying to go for the pin, I would imagine with a minute left, that has got to be one of the longest minutes ever you could try to have.
Oh, absolutely, Coach. Absolutely. All right, there he has the cradle locked up. He needs to work on flipping his hips so we can get him over on his back. Ah, he almost had it.
36 seconds. The clock is off by about 2 seconds on your screen. This is the third period.
And you see Hudson's opponent right here. He's fine just staying stationary, trying to prevent the takedown. Don't try to move too much to make sure that Hudson doesn't get to his pinning combinations.
That will do it in the 141. Noel gets an 11-6 win over Hudson Herring as the competitors shake hands. So we move on to 149. Kaysen Kinney for Tice for Ouachita. Two quick ones for Kenny. So a 2-0 lead for Carl Albert. Keeping that foot in there, not wanting to get out. Now they're out and they'll restart.
He got off to a really quick start there, Coach Babb. He got quick with the hand fight and dropped down to the ankle, low single, right to Alex's. Right below Alex's sprawl, which is really, really good to get that quick takedown to initiate it right now. And now he's on top, trying to look for a turn.
Still no points awarded. There's the near fall. He had the four fingers ready to point him up in the air. It just took a little bit for Kenny to secure those points.
Yes, sir. Once you expose their back, Coach, once you still have a hold of that, they're not going to award you the four until you switch off to a new move. So he was just waiting for Alex's opponent to switch off to a new move so he can award him that four. And that's one escape for Alex Tice.
One escape for Alex. I think Wichita was hoping it'd be a reversal. Big takedown. And close to a pin. 30 seconds left, and there's the pin. So Kenny gets a win by pin at the 27 seconds left in the first period. Good effort that time by Kenny. He got the head was up 8-1 in points, but then ended up getting the pin.
Yes, sir.
We move to the 157 for Wichita, Jalen Otero. And for Carl Albert, this is Alec Capehart.
Let me just tell you a little bit of what Alec's feeling right now, Coach Babb. Whenever I was wrestling my freshman year and I would wrestle around with Jalen Otero, I'll tell you, that was probably the heaviest hands I've ever felt, Coach. So I know he's feeling it right now.
These two teams have wrestled each other as Jalen Otero gets two quick ones on the board for Wichita. These two teams have wrestled earlier this season. I believe Wichita won that match. Not going to get the same credit and scores and credit that you would with a four-year a Division II school, but Otero 3-1 now is a come under 2 minutes to go here in the first period.
Really good fakes, really good movement here by Jalen, trying to open up Alec to get to the scores that he wants to. He's snapping, get him into front head, going behind, faking, making him move so he can get to his own stuff. Really, really good here by Jalen.
Chris Babb with Ricky Rogers Jr., thankfully. So those at home didn't have to just sit and watch a camera and pick up our microphone. We were hoping to get a better little crowd mic, but couldn't quite get it going. So we're thankful that you stopped by, Rick. Five-one now, Otero with 2 points, getting control. Once you get that left hand behind your back, there's not a whole lot you can do. You know, Rick, obviously, I don't think anybody at home is going to be surprised to say that to find out that I haven't watched a ton of wrestling. But anytime I do, when I would watch you guys in high school or at the state meets, some of the positions that the bodies get in and the shoulders getting pulled back, that has to be a tough position to be able to come back from. As Otero looks like he's trying to get a submission or a pin.
Yes, sir. It looks like he has that cradle locked up, the same move that Hudson had in earlier. Just barely had it, almost had it.
Seconds left in the period. And that will do it for the first period. 4-1 is the score.
Jalen has won the toss, Coach, so he's going to start on bottom here at the beginning of the second period.
Quick stop.
We got a caution for Jalen Otero starting before the whistle. Usually when that happens, they're going to give him a caution, and then if he does it again, they're going to take away a point or give the other guy a point.
Back to 5 now as Otero gets out of it.
as I mentioned earlier, Jalen is really, really good at getting his opponent down in that front head to get to his scoring combinations. And he's got that cradle locked up, coach.
Second time he's been close, but Capehart's been able to kind of get out of that, get at least back to where you're just under control and not almost pinned.
Yes, sir.
Under a minute to go here in the second period.
Nice tilt here by Jalen to get some back points.
And 5 seconds left before period two ends. And Rick, as you go into period three, you've exhausted your body. And what are you feeling as this third period's getting started?
Well, usually in this third period, your legs are getting kind of tired from being in that stance. Your neck's hurting from all that hand fighting. But coach, honestly, it's been Jalen this whole match. So I think Jalen and his opponent are feeling pretty fine right now.
Capehart does get the point for getting out of that one. Imagine there's a little bit of adrenaline that kicks in during that third period, too.
Oh, absolutely. You got 2 minutes left. You're trying to finish the match strong. Adrenaline definitely kicking in right now.
Points for Otero, having control.
That was a really great setup there by Jalen, coach. He managed to duck the head down because he's been getting him in that front head all match. When he ducked down, the guy was expecting to come to a front head, but then Jalen dove under for the high crotch and took him down. Really, really great setup by Jalen.
So we're in the exact opposite situation as we were in the previous match when it was a 7-point lead and Carl Albert's wrestler was on the bottom just trying to conserve energy. Now Jalen's on top in control, and he could continue and try to go for the pin, or he can try to get the rest of this clock as well and to maintain control and not let him out.
Yes, sir. I believe right here Jalen's trying to score some more points for his team, because the more points you score, the more points will go over to overall team score.
Right. Twenty seconds left, 9-3 as Capehart gets out of that one. Two more for Otero.
Really great takedown there and right transition right into the tilt to try to get some back points. You can definitely tell Jalen's fighting for that major decision.
15-3. Is the final in the 157, Jalen Otero with the victory. And are we moving to 174? Is this 174 or is anybody in 165?
No, sir, this is 165, and this is Brady Marple for Wichita.
So 165, getting ready to get going. Marple for Wichita. And for Carl Albert in the 165, We have two names here, Foster or Rhodes. Can't tell what's on that screen down there either.
That's going to be two takedown for Brady Marple. Started off the match tied up with his opponent. Managed to duck under that to a shot right up to the body and took him down with the mat return. Right now has a half locked up, trying to get him down to his hips so they can put him on his back.
Trying his close, Rick. What's the official looking for here? Trying to look for that pin?
So he's looking for both of the shoulder blades to be on the mat so he can call that pin. Right there, he didn't feel like both shoulder blades are on the mat, but still a lot of back points for Brady Marple right there.
So four for the near fall and then one for the escape for Carl Albert. So 6-1, Marple with 1:15 remaining in the first period. And the 165.
The shot there by Rhodes. Brady Marple did a really good job of getting his legs and hips back to get behind for the two.
So 10-1 now with 40 seconds left in the first period. One for the escape, so 10-2.
Right here, both opponents just feeling each other out, trying to feel the other hand fight.
The untrained eye, it looked like Rhodes tried to go in for one and Marple was there to get advantage of it and was able to get two when I don't think Rhodes was really thinking he was going to be able to give up any points there. So,
yes, sir.
So at the end of the first period, 12-2.
Brady Marple here chose bottom at the beginning of the second period. So Rhodes will have the choice if it goes to the third period. A very well-timed roll there from Brady Marple, feeling how Rhodes was switching from side to side to get up. And way to use that underhook right over to the knee pick to take him down for another two. Very, very smart wrestling here by Brady Marple.
14-2, so you're close to a tech fall, but then one slip, one misplay, and then you're on your back and you're pinned. So there's no such thing as letting up or anything like that. I would think if you're in this position, you have to continue because one miscue can flip it around just as quickly.
Yes, sir. You can't ease up at all because in a wrestling match, anything can happen. Anybody can slip. Anybody can end up on their back. So Brady Marple right here is going to fight for that tech fall and try to put more points on the board.
Five seconds remaining in the second period. Three, escape. And so 20 seconds remaining. This is where Marple got 2 points in the first period in these last 20 seconds.
Shot attempt there by Rhodes. Brady was able to feel it out and run out of the.
Washita wanting points, but the official deemed that we're out of play, out of bounds, and out of the circle, so we'll go to third period. Not 20 minutes. I guess that'd be kind of tough to wrestle for 20 minutes straight, wouldn't it, Rick? Start the third period.
What'll be interesting to see here, Coach, is if Brady Marple will ride him out or if he'll let him up and try to take him down to get the tech fall. Hip highs by Rhodes to get back on his feet. Shot in by Rhodes, and we're out of bounds. Brady Marple doing a really, really good job of getting his hips back whenever Rhodes shoots in to prevent Rhodes from taking him down.
Under 1 minute to go in the third period here in the 165. 174 will be next.
Brady Marple putting legs in here on top of Rhodes, hoping that that'll be a way to open him up so that he can find a way to put him on his back for some back points or hopefully a pin.
Well, upon 30 seconds to go here in period three. Did give 2 points to Carl Albert. So 17-9 ends the match with Brady Marple with the victory. He kind of controlled that one early and held on. So we'll move to the 174 weight class. Had a couple of options for both teams. We'll see who lines up for Washita. Cole Eason. It'll be Eason for Washita. We can tell for Carl Albert who that is. Alex Foster, I think, is who they have. We have him in a different weight class, but that's all right. We'll go with it.
Foster starting off this match with really, really good fakes connected with his hand fights. Really, really good movement here by these two.
A lot of jockeying here in this first minute.
Foster now has dug in an underhook, trying to use that to his advantage to score here on Eason.
Coach, thinks he should have gotten a point there. What's he protesting here with the official?
He's protesting that he had control over him before they went out of bounds. But from the looks of it, they're not going to give him that two.
So no points awarded.
Really good shot here by Foster, bringing it up in a single leg, trying to finish. A scramble here for positioning. With Eason coming out on top with the two.
Eason, a freshman from Cabot, Arkansas. Under a minute to go.
Eason here doing a really, really good job, Coach Babbitt, keeping him flat, making sure that he doesn't build his base to get out so that he can work on his pinning combinations. Right now, he's got that arm behind him.
There's
able to put him on his back.
4-3-2-1, and that is the end of the first period. And so Eason really close to a pin there as the first period wound down. But not enough there for the official, and we go to the second period.
Eason is going to start on bottom at the beginning of the second period. Good mat return here by Foster, but really good recovery here by Eason as well.
Flip him over, and here we go. Second chance for a pin. There it is, and the pin, Chris Eason by pin at 144 in the second period. Ricky, it's one of those things where you can control and then you're not, and Chris Eason got a quick pin.
Yes, sir. Like I told you, those legs are really hard, but once you get your hips up and able to put them on their back, really, really good there by Eason.
So now we move up to 184. William Martin for Ouachita. They're ready to go quick, aren't they? And I think they said Mason for Carl Albert.
Eason
quick two for Mason.
William Martin doing a really good job here of keeping him at the edge. Mason shooting in, bringing it up to a single leg. Martin doing a really, really good job of defending here. Martin able to get out of that single leg.
William Martin, a 5'10", 195-pound sophomore, business administration management major from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma.
Jockeying for position right here. Martin, as I mentioned earlier, is doing a really, really good job of keeping his butt to the center of the mat, making Mason come back into him, and that'll really help him set up his shots.
Discipline that it takes during season to stay in weight class and make your weight and maybe have to cut. It's just almost a discipline unlike any other from any other sport, I would imagine.
Absolutely, Coach. Just having to cut the amount of weight that these guys have to do and then on the same day having to go and wrestle against another person who's doing the exact same thing. It's a discipline like no other.
Oh, equipment malfunction, 2-1 the score as we update Martin's score there. Well, headgear issue, you know, having spare headgear in your vehicle, you could put a bar.
I think I left it at home, Coach.
Gotcha.
Trust, I'd give it to him.
I gotcha. How many years did you wrestle from the time you started to the time you finished?
So I wrestled from the 6th grade to my freshman year in college. So for a little
almost,
while.
Yeah. lots of miles traveled and lots of wrestling meets and a couple of state championships as well in Arkansas.
Yes,
you weren't
going
to mention it, so I figured I would.
Great shot there by Mason. A low-level shot, single leg. But Martin doing a really good job wizarding here, trying to keep his weight down on Mason so that he can't come up with it.
Under a minute to go. See the official clock there in the background behind the referee. 50 seconds now. We're off by a couple of seconds. Still 2-1, and now Mason gets two more for having control. And 4-2 now as Martin escapes.
Shot here by Martin at the edge of the mat. Bringing it up to a single leg, trying to finish here. But just pushed out of bounds.
So officially 31 seconds remaining in the first period. Washita's had two pins, one tech fall. Carl Albert had a pin. Don't have the updated point total for the entire match, but we'll see if we can't get that after the end of the last match. We do have the matches and a couple of exhibition matches as well.
Both men locked up here in an over-under position right at the end of the period.
So end of the period, 4-2 the score. Mason and Carl Albert leads Martin.
Martin's going to start on bottom at the beginning of the second period, meaning Mason will have the choice at the beginning of the third.
Martin gets the point. Getting out, and 4-3, Mason with the lead.
Really good urgency here by William Martin, just getting up quick and getting straight into his hand fighting to try to take Mason down. Very very tough hand fight here from both men, trying to open the other up to try to get to the legs.
Almost halfway through this second round. 1 minute remaining here in the second round in the 184 between William Martin, Ouachita, and Mason of Carl Albert. Seconds remaining in the second period. Still neutral. They've been neutral this whole second period. Only anybody's had control. The points had the one point at the very beginning of the round. But when you go 2 minutes like this, where it's kind of a stalemate, nobody's had control, what's your mentality going into round three?
The mentality going around three here, Coach Babb, is just continuing the tough hand fight, because both of these wrestlers have really, really good hand fighting. That's why no one's able to get down to the legs. So right here in this third period, as we talked about earlier, you really want to focus on your conditioning. You want to focus on your discipline to try to open up the other guys so that you can get to your takedowns. Mason starting here on bottom. Really good see getting up to a quad pod, trying to get to his feet for the escape. But Martin doing a really, really good job of staying heavy.
And Mason gets the point for getting it back to neutral, 5-3, and here we go with the good hand fighting, trying to get position, trying to get to gain some control.
Yes, sir, and Martin's definitely doing that right here, trying to fight for his underhooks, trying to get down to a leg. Urgency right here, because he's down by 2 points, so he's definitely picking up the pace right here in this third period, trying to get to his takedowns. Shot attempt there by William Martin, but Mason doing a really good job. Reshot there. Able to pick Mason up. Scramble position here. Jockeying for position. William Martin is down on a leg. And they're going to call stalemate and bring him back to their feet.
Seconds remaining in the 184. Next will be 197.
With 30 seconds left, William Martin is picking up the pace right here, trying to put it on Mason, but it's very hard to score on a guy like Mason who's been able to keep his hips down, to keep his hand fighting active, to keep Martin off of his legs. Shot attempt there by Martin, but Mason doing a very good job of defending it.
Seconds, 1 point match. And that's how the 184 ends, with a 5-4 decision for Mason. We go to 197. Start the 197. Brooks Scrimshire Carlo for Carl Albert. Two quick ones for Scrimshire.
Yes, sir, and already working for a cradle. Able to get him down to his hip, trying to bring him to his back, but just barely misses.
I would imagine when you're the wrestler that does find yourself on your back, it's almost a helpless feeling. You're just trying to do anything you can do to not have your shoulders go down any way to try to get back to even where he is now, much less neutral.
Yes, sir, definitely. When you get on your back, it's definitely code red, and you're doing all you can to just to fight to get on your stomach. And right here, Brooks did a really good job of grabbing that bar arm and getting him over for the tilt to get some back points.
So four more for Scrimshire, 6-2.
Very quick takedown there by Brooks.
9-2 now. Scrimshire, a sophomore finance major from Huntsville, Alabama. Under a minute to go here in period one, the 197.
Brooks right here, coach, is really, really fighting for that bar arm to get to his tilt, a really, really effective move as far as getting back points. But his opponent is doing a really, really good job of fighting that.
Ten seconds remaining in the first period. And that is how first period ends.
Brooks right here has won the toss at the beginning of the second period, and he is choosing bottom. And his opponent will get the choice at the beginning of the third. Great urgency by Brooks right here to get up to his feet and get the escape and right into the hand fight. High crotch attempt here by Brooks, bringing it up and able to bring him down for 2 points.
So three total in the period for Scrimshire, 12-2. Albert State College made the trip over from Oklahoma.
And at this point right here, coach, Brooks has really had no trouble getting to his tilts, getting to his takedown. So I have to believe that he's trying to get that tech fall to give Wichita more points over at the team total.
Five seconds remaining in the second period. And DiCarlo gets his point. Two more for control, so 28 seconds remaining.
Yes, sir, and Brooks is doing a really, really good job at when his opponent gets up, getting right back into the hand fight and getting right back into his takedowns.
10 seconds remaining in the second period. And it looks like they will just wait this one out and get on to period three. So 14-3 as we start the third period.
Yes, Coach, and I believe up by 11 points right here, Brooks just needs a couple more takedowns to get the Tech fall. And it looks like he's going to start with an optional start. This is whenever you just put your hands on your opponent while they're on bottom, allowing them to get up.
Now. Minute to go now. And there's the Tech fall for Scrimshire. Officially 51 seconds remaining in the third period. So now we move to that's incorrect. 285, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I was like, this is not 185. The lineup we had for Washtenaw's had 185, but that's definitely not 185. Johnny Green's 185. If Johnny Green's 185, I'm 400. Emmett Bivens for Carl Albert.
Early takedown there by Johnny Green, able to get to his double unders and to shake it by and finish with a mat return. Now trying to ride heavy to get to his turns right at the edge of the mat, and they're going to be out of bounds. They're going to give a caution to Johnny Green for not lining up properly. They're going to restart right here.
Yeah. Under a minute to go here in the first.
Johnny Green is doing a really good job here, Coach, at keeping Bivens stationary.
Johnny Green was recognized earlier, senior, for senior night from Allen, Texas, 6'4", 285. Green was a 2019 heavyweight state champion in high school at Allen. 2-0 at the end of the first.
Bivens has won the toss, and he did a little bit different from everybody else. He's choosing neutral to start off the second period, feeling that he's a better chance on the feet at taking Johnny Green down. Shot there by Bivens, but Johnny doing a good job of putting his weight down and going around for the two. Johnny Green right here is digging for a chicken wing, trying to use that to put Bivens on his back.
Rick, I could use a chicken wing right now myself, but probably not the kind of wrestling, right?
Me and you both, Coach.
Yeah. Bivens' headgear kind of falling in front of the eyes. Does that kind of mess with you a little bit if your headgear is out of place, or do you even notice it when you're in the moment like that?
When you're in a moment like that, Coach, you really don't even notice it.
You hear that thud from here, even with the headsets off. Under a minute to go in the second period.
Notice right here, Coach, how Johnny Green is keeping his shins on the back of Bivens' kneecaps. That's preventing him from kind of going anywhere, preventing him from building his base, which is allowing Johnny Green to keep him down and to work for his pinning combinations.
Another takedown. The slap of the mat after he landed on that one.
Coach, I'd be doing the same thing if, if
Johnny Green's taking me down.
Yes, sir, absolutely.
I don't think I would give up as much challenge as Bivens has. Well, I don't think there's no think to it. I know I wouldn't. And that is how round two ends, still 4-0.
Johnny Green's choice here, and he's choosing to go down on bottom, hoping to get up and score that 1 point for escape and then get back to neutral and take Bivens down again.
Out of it, so 5-0, another takedown. Seven for control. Looks like Bivens is trying to see at this point, trying to get out of bounds to restart.
Yes, sir. He's trying to get that knee out of bounds so that they can do what they're doing right now, starting
right
back in the center of the mat where he started up in a referee's position where his base, so he can, it'll be easier for him to get up right here.
1:15 left. 7-1 as Bivens gets out of it.
Johnny Green is selecting to go with the optional start. Shot here by Bivens, but again, really good job here by Johnny Green by getting his hips down and getting behind for the 2 points.
It's the second time Bivens trying to shoot low, and Green's been able to get around.
Yes, sir. When you're going against a man as big as Johnny Green, it's kind of hard to get under him.
Five seconds remaining in the heavyweight match.
The score 9-2 here, Johnny Green winning by 7 points plus the riding time point, coach. He'll finish with a major decision if he can manage to stay on top of Bivens for the remainder of this period.
Only 10 seconds left in the period, and it looks like that's probably how it will end.
Stalling called on Bivens, giving Johnny Green the point.
So 10-2, the final in the heavyweight match with Green and Bivens. Johnny Green with the win for Ouachita. So now a couple of exhibition matches. Alex Pena for Ouachita. Definitely not the 285 weight class. Pena listed, I believe, 149. Is that? Like that name that is on the screen is a long name, and I do not have one of those on my list. Let our clock catch up.
Pena managed to escape here back in neutral. Coach Ash on the Ouachita bench encouraging Pena to move his feet. Shot attempt there, but is defended really well. Wrestling here at the edge of the mat. Trying to go behind, but we're going to go out of bounds before anything can happen. Another shot attempt there, but doing a really, really good job of keeping his stance low so that he can't get to his legs. Bringing him back up and trying to use his footwork, as Coach has mentioned earlier, moving his feet so that he can open him up to get to his shots.
This is one of, I believe, two exhibition matches, so we'll have one more match after this one, I believe.
Pena starting on top here.
Points for control, so Pena down.
Pena was doing a really, really good job at following his opponent's hips and staying on top, but his opponent did a really good job of hip heisting, getting Pena off onto his hip and able to reverse it for the 2 points.
Pena, a freshman from Searcy, Arkansas.
Shot there by Pena's opponent. But all match, Pena's been doing a very, very good job of keeping his hips back so that he can't get taken down. Now here trying to work behind for the score, and he gets it.
All tied up at 4. 40 seconds left in the second period.
Tied here 4-4, Coach. I believe that Pena is trying to get to his tilts, trying to get to his pinning combinations to get some back points before the start of the third period.
And that's how the second period will end.
Pena with the decision at the beginning of the third period, and he's elected to start at the bottom position.
Well, another little headgear malfunction.
Quick urgency by Pena to get up to his feet, trying to fight the hand so he can get escape over at the edge of the mat. Nothing yet here because his opponent still has a hold of his legs. Stalling called on his opponent though.
Get his knees out.
Right there, Coach Pinion was able to get to his feet, fight those hands, and then managed to get his opponent down so he could get that reversal. Very, very good job there by Pinion. Both of these wrestlers picking up the pace here with a minute left to go. It's a technical violation called on Pena for locked hands while on top. They're going to give a point to his opponent. Pena working really hard here, Coach, to keep his opponent down. Try not to let him up and give him that point to tie up the score.
Seconds remaining in the third period, 6-5. About as close a match as we've had this evening.
Absolutely, Coach. His opponent trying to build his base to get out to tie the score, but Pena doing a really good job of keeping his weight on him to keep him down.
Long 10 seconds. That might have been the last ditch effort to try to get up, and once he went back down, that was gonna be it. So 6-5 was the final. Alex Pena with the victory in that exhibition match. Donald Paul, this is a 285 exhibition.
These two heavyweights starting off really aggressive with the hand fight. Donald Paul able to get him down to a front head, and he turns it to a cradle, trying to get his opponent over to his back.
Hudgens for Carl Albert. Trey Hudgens.
Donald Paul letting go of that cradle and just settling for the two. Now trying to work on top, flattening him out to get him over on his back. Donald Paul making it very hard on his opponent to get up by following him and grabbing hold of those wrists to keep him down flat on the ground.
Minute 15 left in round one of what we believe is our final exhibition match of the evening.
They're going to call a stall warning on Donald Paul, initiating that. He isn't doing much on top, but to be honest with you, Coach, I don't know if I could do much on bottom if I was wrestling him.
See him, Hudgens grabbing that foot, trying to get it out of there. I would imagine that he's able to get control of his ankle and foot. He's able to kind of have Paul lose some of that leverage he has.
Yes, sir. Donald Paul was trying to put legs in right there to control his opponent a little bit more, but Hudgenson doing a really good job of preventing him by blocking his hips and grabbing the foot and pushing it out. Donald Paul winning the toss at the beginning of the second period. He's going to start on bottom. Hudgens will start on top. Donald Paul quick to a quad paw position, coming up to his feet, trying to fight hands to get the escape. Hudgens right there trying to mat return Donald Paul, but he finds a way to get his hips out for the reversal, and now has put him on his back trying to look for the pin.
There it is, and that is a pin for Donald Paul in the 285 exhibition, and that is going to be the last match of the evening. For Ricky Rogers, I am Chris Babb. Thanks to Wyatt Ashlock, Chloe Velleman, and Hannah Hickman, along with Isaac Edwards, for working this broadcast of the Wichita Sports Digital Network. Ricky, thanks for joining us.
Yes,
appreciate
sir.
It.
Thank you for having me, Coach.
Thanks for bailing me out and helping out a whole lot. So, again, a good match between Wichita, a good duel between Wichita and Carl Albert State College, and you can check obutigers.com for all of the results. Thanks for tuning in to the Wichita Sports Digital Network. Good night, everybody. Have a great rest of the week.